circumstances he was given and became a legend. That is what a speaker said today of Mel Tillis, a performer and songwriter who racked more than 35 top 10 hits. With Tillis' passing 2 months ago, many familiar faces came together today to say goodbye. News 4's Ford Sanders has the story from the Rock.
I ain't never. It first charted on Billboard's Hot Country Songs in 1959. Around the rival, still loves it today. A 1972 version topped the country singles chart. The first number one for Mel Tillis, growing up in Florida with a stutter brought on by childhood malaria. Tillis' musical drive formed during late nights listening to the Grand Ole Opry.
Tillis first visited Nashville in 1956, moved here the next year, began writing songs, more than 1,000 songs. It was through those songs he became known here in the city.
There's something cross-generational about the music, something Tillis' children know well, three of them being Mel Jr., Carrie, and Pam.
I think it was the honesty.
The tributes keep coming from his rogue family, the band. The longtime backup singers he dubbed the Stutterettes. Friends like Ralph Emery, Corey Morgan, Ricky Skaggs, the Gaffney Brothers, Ray Stevens.
You're just a